Well, good afternoon and welcome to Bloemfontein. We find ourselves overlooking Rocklands as the Dr Pietros Molemela Stadium serves as the venue for this afternoon's Nedbank Cup quarterfinal tie. It is Bloemfontein Celtic, your host, Lamontville Golden Arrows, in a match in which there'll be no room for sentiment, with many of the players, particularly from Golden Arrows, having previously represented today's opponents. Left boot, well, not dealt with by anybody from either side. And Fenter's delivery into that area is just casually rolled through that 18-yard area. Fenter, and wide. Okay, Danny Fenter, not too far away from seeing that ball. It's toward the top corner. Sabengo here trying the 1-2. Searching for a way through the Montville Golden Arrows. Danny Fenter is encouraging the players ahead of him. Space here. Sabengo doesn't take the shot first time or even second time. Eventually unleashes a shot. We finally got a shot on target in the game. Bilakulu comes through and cuts out any chance for Bloemfontein Celtic, and this is stayed onside. Lerato Lamola with a good little run. Square ball to come. Chance here to win it, perhaps, and indeed the substitutes combine. Knox Mutizwa buries a ball that was provided from Lerato Lamola with 20 minutes to play. The visiting team lead, a Celtic side that they've not beaten in some time. Splendid play from Lerato Lamola. Knox Mutizwa with the finish. His seventh goal of the season, his first cup goal, incidentally. And this ball played in behind the Celtic defence. Lamola stayed onside brilliantly and saw a man in space with only one player back in Kuberi. Seeing that Letualo is potentially the option. Tani with a cross into a danger area, too close to Mbaeva. The man who's over the moon for helping Namibia qualify for their third Africa Cup of Nations finals. Ball driven in here. Celtic searching for a comeback and they've found it. Bongani Sam with only his second goal of this season. A league goal against Pirates and a crucial cup equaliser against Arrows here. Maybe that unbeaten record largely for Celtic against Arrows is to remain intact. With 20 minutes to play, Arrows scored. With 10 minutes to play, Celtic scored. Maybe there will be an additional half hour of extra time to come. Mbaeva beaten. So the winner of this tie will go on to face either TS Galaxy, already beaten Cape Moya United, and the winner of Bidvest Wits, Chippy United, and the winner of Kaiser Chiefs and Cape Town City is Mabena. Again breaks into a danger area, tries a shot at goal, and that ball skewing slightly off the side of his boot and away rather than hitting the target. So many sports. Chance here for Bloemfontein Celtic now inside the area. Letualo lays it back, and a ball that's off target from Masugu. There was an option potentially to try to feed for another. That's Letualo, who made that charging run into the danger area, maybe overran it, left it behind for Masugu, and then a ball in ahead of Mabena. Yusta recovers possession for Arrows. Ball drilled in lower, flatter. Oh, Lingwati's clearance is not significant. And indeed, in trying to win the ball back here from the debutant Matanjwa, he has committed the foul that sees a free kick awarded in the penalty arc. So on the edge of that 18-yard area, Lingwati off his feet. Mutizwa! Oh! Strikes home for Arrows, an arrow to the heart of Celtic's Nedbank Cup campaign, surely. Knox Mutizwa off the bench scores a double, and Arrows scoring in 10-minute increments in this match. Mutizwa scored at 70, Sam leveled at 80, and as 90 minutes came up, Mutizwa hits it home. Bongani Sam's consolation goal couldn't dent Mutizwa's double. Let's see Arrows advance.
Again, you say the game of the two teams that you can see, they were both cautious, especially first half. We could see both teams were cautious, and you could see Waterman, he knows this team very well, and he held his card close to his chest up until we're also doing the same. We could see that the bench, this team were saying that it will be won back from the bench. And they managed to get a goal, and then we had to release now and go and attack and try to find a goal. Fortunately, we knew what was coming, and we worked on it, and then it's very unfortunate that we conceded the first, especially the first goal from transition, and the man, the striker, find himself alone, Lamola. Of course, he still had some running to do, even when he played it across to Mutizwa. Those are the combination that has been working for Golden Arrows. I don't think there's any coach that is preparing against Golden Arrows that is not going to talk about Mutizwa and Lamola. But look, it's one of those things that, unfortunately, if we don't learn and we do that such mistakes and we repeat the mistakes, they will hurt us. Look at the goal. Carbon copy, I don't think I just need to go and watch the league game. Same free kick, and we worked on it. We knew that around there they'll extend the wall, they'll try to block the keeper, but we shouldn't allow the opponents to be on the wall, because as soon as they play the ball, they're gonna clear the path, and then it's a goal. But well, we fought. I'm happy with the way we played second, especially second half, and exactly the way we planned it, that come second half we're gonna release and then we will sure get a goal. But it's one of those games that it's a cup game, it's a typical cup game.
Coach, you've talked about the way that you conceded today, but in a cup quarterfinal, did you expect a little bit more going forward? Did you get enough today to think that you should have won this?
Look, Golden Arrows is a team that you have to box smart and be mindful, because there is a team with speed. And if you open up, we had to wait for the right moments, but I think first half we are not playing, we're just sitting in the block, and when we get the ball, we couldn't go forward, we couldn't even connect the passes. So I can say first half we struggled a bit to come out, and I think we could have done better first half, and then maybe the results could have been better.
Tough luck today, coach.
Thank you very much.
Julia, I think one compliment must be given to Bloemfontein Celtic. They play a good brand of football, the coaches are doing a good job, they gave us a good match, and it could have gone either way. We were more opportunistic, but one thing I must also highlight was the grass a bit dry, it was a bit hot, but you should be delighted for going through to the next round. And I thought there were moments where we took good control of the match, we played well, we passed the ball well, but the speed was not there. It was a little bit more lethargic, and also Bloemfontein Celtic, but the effect of Mabena, you could feel he brought some energy. And for us, the two subs made a big difference. And compliment must also be given to Mutizwa. Two goals again. Even when we played here, he scored almost a similar goal from a set play. So it's good to see that. But we knew a free kick in and around the box, something could come up.
Before the game, you had said, given the heat, the first kind of half, the first 30, 40 minutes would be very slow. So was that always the plan, to keep the two of them on the bench for the second half?
Partly so, but as well informed by the FIFA week, the preparations. Knox had gone to the national team. Lamola had a bit of Knox. Beko was doing well. Sabelo was doing well. Chenene was doing well. Nduando was doing well. Now you said, okay. But there's something we did at training on Thursday. We threw both of them, and immediately there was a spark. Sometimes you neglect such, and God is giving you a message that these are the ones who are going to win a match for you. So you gotta be alert, read that, and be online with the messages.
You and these messages and divine intervention. Just a final question for you, coach. No side from KwaZulu-Natal has won the Nedbank Cup. Will you and your players be dreaming yet?
I wish to go as far as possible, and God willing, let them win it, not for me. Julia, again, with utmost respect, my main priority is sticking to values. Values, but you will come and go, but values are important. The minute you teach a team how to play with character within a particular set of values, value will follow. Me, I don't care. As long as they do well, the club does well. When they win the trophy, I wish I should not be there. I should be somewhere, somebody must win it. That's the name of the game. That's how I look at life.